Hey, I'm Kendra, and today I am super excited to share with you about Ayurvedic cooking and how life-changing it can be. At its core, it's about understanding what your body needs on a physiological level. It's really a practice of observation and response. It's a conversation between you and your body. Rather than defining what it is, I want to talk a little bit about what it isn't. First of all, Ayurvedic cooking is not a fad or a diet. A diet really implies that something is used short term, whereas Ayurvedic cooking is implemented for life. It really isn't centered around any goal other than having good digestion and finding balance in your body. It isn't about restrictions or limitations. What you're going to be doing is working to increase and decrease the foods that work best for your constitution. The first thing that you need to know about Ayurvedic cooking is that it is all about digestibility. How easily can your body break down food into the nutrients that you need to fuel yourself? If you don't have strong digestion, you're going to be experiencing things like gas, bloating, constipation, loose stools. Nobody really likes that. If you have strong digestion, however, first of all, you're not going to really experience any of those things, and you're going to have regular elimination. I mean regular elimination. Maybe so regular you could set your alarm clock to it, if you know what I mean. And you're gonna have an easier time tolerating bad food combinations for quite some time. Which brings us to the next idea, food combining. Food combining is such a hot topic. And in Ayurveda, it's this idea that certain foods, when paired, challenge your digestion, right? It all comes back to digestibility. So a good example of this might be mixing complex proteins, for example, beans and nuts. Those are heavy, rich foods, and it's more challenging for your body to break that down. But we have a ton of guides about this on our website, so go check it out there. Another component of Ayurvedic cooking is using spices, right? Using spices for more than just imparting flavor. Spices have the ability to support our overall digestive process. For example, if you are having some of that gas and bloating and need to dispel some air elements, you might try some fennel seed. Herbs and vegetables have different tastes. In Ayurveda, ideally you'll have all six tastes in most of your meals, and that's sweet, salty, sour, bitter, pungent, and astringent. Now this is where it gets cool. The ratio of those flavors is what you can tweak to make your meal more balancing for your unique constitution. So let's talk about another concept in Ayurvedic cooking, that of praniful foods. In Sanskrit, prana also means your vitality and your life force. And so when you consume foods that are high in prana, you're nourishing yourself with that vitality. Now, how do you identify what a praniful food is? Well, first of all, when you go to the grocery store, pretty much anything that's in the center is not going to be praniful food, right? It's been heavily processed. If you've ever had the experience of pulling a carrot straight out of the ground and eating it, then you know on a personal level what a praniful food feels like. Its taste enlivens you, right? It tastes so good. Basically, the closer to the harvest and the dirt, the better. Lastly, all of these beautiful concepts really mean nothing without one more idea, and that's your mindset. So in Ayurveda, if you're stressed and angry while you're cooking or eating your food, that food is going to be imbued with that energy. And if you really think about it, right, if you're angry and you're cooking, your attention is elsewhere. You're more likely to burn your food or overseason it. So really approach all of your meal prep and consumption with that mindset of loving kindness. I really hope that you're as excited about Ayurvedic cooking as I am. And if you'd like to learn more, then go ahead and subscribe to our channel. If you have any questions at all, leave your comments below. Thank you so much for watching.